Welcome to Demo, the show where companies come in and show us their latest products and services. I'm Keith Shaw. Joining me on the show today is Julian Weitz. He is the Vice President of Sales for Makersite. So Julian, welcome to the show. And what is Makersite and what product are you going to show us today?
So we at Makersite, we help with our AI-powered product lifecycle intelligence solution, manufacturing enterprises solve the most complex analysis of their products and supply chains across the areas of sustainability, compliance, costing, and supply chain.
Yeah. And what's your main role of, like, who would benefit most within a company for this type of product?
Nowadays, at most manufacturing enterprises, it's really the CIO that's been mandated to solve a lot of different challenges across the business departments that need a solution like ours. Whether it is the sales department that needs to deliver certain analysis towards their customers, whether it is corporate sustainability, where all these regulations mostly driven out of Europe need to be solved. You have the procurement department that needs to decarbonize the supply chain, for example, and you have the product engineering group that, you know, nowadays needs to automate and consider more more aspects when in the design stage, such as areas of sustainability and costs.
All right, and so as a CIO is looking at a bunch of products that are being manufactured, they might see that, wow, a lot of the components here are not sustainable. So you help them find new suppliers or new ways of becoming more sustainable, correct?
Exactly. And that without needing an expert by your side.
Yeah.
Bear in mind, when you look at product sustainability, there's like 20,000 experts around the world. They cannot consult all the product engineers and all the procurement professionals around there. And this is what really the CIO's job is here, is amplifying this type of expert knowledge with our AI technology within that company.
Right. So if they didn't have a solution like Makersite, they would probably have to go and interview 20,000 different people. What would companies do if they didn't have this?
So they would struggle with a lot of business aspects. Yeah. I can tell you one example, and Microsoft just recently in a webcast spoke about this. They're one of our key clients. They use Makersite to measure all the hardware components that drive the Azure cloud or their, you know, consumer devices. And they basically equip tons of engineers that, you know, look at making a more sustainable cloud configuration, and they simply stated they wouldn't be able to do it. It's not about even hiring most of the experts around the globe. It just would not be feasibly possible to analyze at that rapid speed that many components. If you think about it, we're talking about a complex device like a laptop here that is made out of thousands of parts.
Yeah.
Thousands of materials.
All right, so let's jump into the demo and show us some of the key features of the product.
Absolutely, and I'll take you through an example of a simple household appliance that you need for this laptop, which is a computer mouse.
Okay.
And what you'll see here is essentially a bill of material. This should be, you know, knowledgeable or recognizable for people that are in product engineering, but I think anyone in IT as well that, you know, administers PLM systems and stuff is recognizing this type of format.
Yeah.
You know, you have level one item, which is the finished good. It goes down to, you know, multiple levels down into, you know, the parts that a company buys, a resistor, integrated circuit, a capacitor. You have like the internal codes in there and stuff.
Okay.
This type of product could take someone to analyze probably a couple of days, maybe 2 weeks.
Yep.
What we do with Makersite here is we're taking this bill of material and we get an analysis within a second. Makersite has applications that you can analyze your products across business parameters, environmental parameters, health and safety, and regulations.
Okay.
The way we are able to do this is we've built the world's largest supply chain and material database. And we take all the data that sits in our customers' environments, in their data landscape, mainly the ERP world, the PLM data landscape, the CAD systems. We bring all that data into our platform and we automatically enrich it with our data and our AI engine. And this is what I'm going to show you now.
Okay.
And for that, I'll upload this bill of material. You have a bunch of different importers, but this bill of material, which I'm now importing, you could also do this through our integration. So This UI could also completely run in the background. Everything is drivable via APIs, so mm-hmm. it could absolutely just be that intelligence layer that sits behind your legacy systems, your ERP system, your PLM system, and enriches all the data points that sit in there with the parameters that we have.
Okay, so they don't have to throw out an existing system to work with this?
Absolutely not. This is an addition and enhancement to what yeah. you have today, basically okay. bridging the data that you have in all these siloed systems and making the most out of it. So what I'll do is I'll drag and drop this bill of material in here, and within seconds this has been analyzed, and we can go right into analysis mode.
Yep.
Now, an expert or somebody that's wants to do data work, they can go into the nitty gritty. They can do a QA report. We'll go right into analysis mode.
Sure.
This took a second. Bear in mind, we have much more complex products. We have companies, they build wind turbines. companies that build manufacturing
right.
equipment, oil drillings. It's really a vast variety. The largest bill of material was a product with roughly 900,000 components. Still took less than 10 minutes to run this.
Wow,
analysis.
Okay.
Now, what you can see here right away, there's a couple of things that we see. We can drill into the supply chain. We see how much the product should cost, which typically you need experts for analysis. You can drill into the supply chain. You see the product environmental footprint, so the carbon emissions, which is a very important topic for a bunch of different regulations,
right.
bunch of different requirements in the organization. You can go into substance risk and the global regulations that apply. Right, compliance is a big topic. We know that a bunch of organizations have struggled with compliance regulations and keeping up with them in the past. And this can cost fines if you're not knowing that you may or may not adhere to a certain regulation in a core operating market.
Okay.
This is just the first glimpse at what we can get out of this product. There's more than 50 applications that we have across business, environmental, health, and safety regulations, and really important is you have one product and supply chain model
mm-hmm.
and all these multi-outputs. So you can really consolidate a lot of the software tooling that's lying around in your organization built for different purposes with our solution. Because you have one model, it's all automated,
yep.
and then you can analyze this model across so many different parameters. Now we will go into the product environmental footprint, the carbon emissions. What you see here is a Sankey diagram. The Sankey diagram is essentially showing us the flow of CO2 through that product, and we can drill deeper and deeper. The great thing is, if you look at this, this doesn't take an expert to understand where the most carbon is coming from, right? We have a product, we have a process in between, and the gray bar basically tells me this is where the most carbon is coming
okay.
from. This is really tailored to users that are not experts, that just need to understand, well, there's the most carbon, okay, I'll focus there and maybe I can optimize there. Now, the most complexity in this mouse sits within the electronics. So we're going into this mouse assembly, and this is where the most interesting things are. You can go into, for example, an electronic, and you buy this electronic. However, we know how this electronic is made. So I can drill in further and can get an analysis of the supply chain of this power management module from on semiconductor, can see how it is made from which components, and I can see what is driving the most carbon emissions. If I go back to that mouse assembly, I can make changes and see right away what they mean. So I can, for example, see this cable and say, well, how about we make this out of copper instead of gold?
Okay.
The platform will right away tell me 12.5% reduction if we do this. These type of analysis, this isn't trivial. Like we've companies like Schaeffler working with us, they use us, for example, to make supply chain analysis and understand if they move a supply chain from one country to another,
right.
what is the impact across a multitude of different aspects.
So with that 12.5% number, it's also looking at things down the supply chain as what, like for making that change, it would then...
This would look
it's
at
not, the... not just from the materials side of things, but also all of the effects afterwards, right?
Yes, yeah. It looks at the total context. So we really look from a raw material extraction of the material down to the finished good and how it is used afterwards with the customer.
Yeah.
So it's really taking the whole life cycle of a product in context. And the great thing is there's so many changes that companies have to undergo today.
Yeah.
Supply chain issues force companies to make rapid changes, and you need to have these analyses at hand right away. And this is what companies use us for. And like I mentioned, Schaeffler, one of the companies that use us predominantly for these type of scenario analysis, because they move a lot of their supply chains out of certain areas in the world to other areas in the world. And they need to make sure it's in line across these dimensions of sustainability,
right,
cost and risk. In regards to using Makersite, not just for one thing, but for a multitude, I also want to show how you can use this right away to understand, is my product compliant, yes or no?
Okay.
For this, we have like these easy reports that are, you know, customizable, that you can easily integrate with your BI solutions. And I can run a compliance status report now on this. And within no time, essentially, I can say, I want to benchmark this versus a regulation in Europe, which is RoHS. And
okay.
I want to know if I'm an infringement of it. And Makersite can tell me right away if I have any compliance infringement in this product. And you essentially see right away, is something compliant? Is, you know, there's a bunch of things that are not compliant in there. I have a bunch of things that are compliant. And then I can go right away and get in touch with my supplier and figure out, well, what is happening there? I can also drill deeper and find the reason which thresholds of certain things like lead have been breached.
Yeah.
And all of that without being an expert at it. And the ability to look at these type of data points at every step of my product life cycle. Like an engineer that just wants to make early considerations of a product design, thinking, could I use this product instead of another?
Can this be used in the beginning part of the design process as well? So as you're designing a new product, to make sure that from the start, because it looks like these were existing products that people were making, but could they use it in the start as well to make sure that their sustainability efforts, or at least they'll have a number of where they are when they start, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And a good example of that is we have a lot of technology partnerships as well, and specifically in the product design area. So we have partnerships with Autodesk, PTC, Ansys.
Okay.
And this is exactly for that reason, because you need this data early on in the design phase, and you need it for existing products to make changes to them. And really, that is what Makersite is all about. Driving change, essentially helping our customers drive sustainable product innovation fast.
All right. Obviously, there's more. You got a ton of features in here. So where can people go for more details to learn more about the whole platform?
So I think the easiest thing is go to makersite.io and get in touch with us. There's, of course, a bunch of more things that we could show you. I think most manufacturers out there, they have tremendous challenges across sustainability and other areas. And we're really the one-stop shop when it comes to your products and your supply chains here. And we can help you with numerous challenges, whether it's regulatory, internal requirements, or customer requirements. And you don't need a bunch of different solutions to solve that.
Okay, Julian Weitz from Makersite. Thanks for the demo.
Thank you so much, Keith.
All right, that's all the time we have for today's episode. Make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, add any thoughts you have below. Join us every month for new episodes of Demo. I'm Keith Shaw. Thanks for watching.